Hello and welcome to Thought for October the 25th. Our readings are 2 Chronicles chapters 21 and 22, Daniel chapter 3, and Acts chapter 1. And our thought is a burning fiery furnace. In Daniel today, we have the account of the faithfulness of Daniel's three companions, those we read about in chapter 1, who, together with him, refused to eat the king's rich food and wine. Now we read how these three refused to bow down to the king's tall golden image. The king warns, "If you do not worship, you shall immediately be cast into a burning fiery furnace. And who is the God who will deliver you out of my hands?" Chapter 3, verse 15. They refuse, saying, "O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If this be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of your hand, O king. But if not, be it known to you, O king, that we will not serve your gods or worship the golden image that you have set up." Verses 17 to 18. This is an example of commitment to God, come what may. A dramatic deliverance follows. There is no other incident like it in the Bible. Well, there are no more kings who had a burning fiery furnace, but there are many accounts of deliverance occurring to those who faithfully follow their God. We will read of several in the book of Acts, which we started reading today. Are there deliverances today? We have heard of answered prayers this year and previous years, but there is an ultimate act of deliverance promised when Jesus, in returning, will send out his angels with a loud trumpet call, and the dead in Christ will rise. Then they who are alive will be caught up with him. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 16 and 17. That day is coming like a thief in the night, so we must watch, as 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 2 tells us. We are going to read in Daniel of a time of trouble such as never has been since there was a nation till that time. "But at that time your people shall be delivered," we read, "every one whose name shall be found written in the book." Chapter 12, verse 1. Clearly, this is the book of life. Paul refers to it in Philippians chapters 4, verse 3, praising those who have labored side by side with me in the gospel, whose names are in the book of life. May we labor together in spreading the true gospel, so that, by the grace of our Savior, our names will be in the book too. Indeed, are already there. It is the most important book in the world. The extent to which there will be a fire at this time of the end is not clear. We rather think that some scriptures, such as 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 10 to 12, are symbolic, but we cannot be sure. But we long for the time Peter describes in the next verse. According to his promise, we are waiting for new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Well, thank you once again for joining us for Thought for the Day, where together we can open up the pages of God's Word, remembering that Word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path.